I'm happy to welcome Fredrik Hörstedt, who is the Vice President of Business of Research Utilization at Chalmers. He's here for the opening remarks. So welcome, Fredrik.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Daniel. Good morning, everyone. As Daniel said, I'm Fredrik Hörstedt. I'm the Vice President Collaboration and Impact at Chalmers University of Technology. And I'm very glad that I got the question to be here and to open up the Chalmers 2015 conference with the conference theme, Make Your Mark. And you will receive some key messages from me in the opening remark. First one being that the chosen theme is highly relevant. Second key message is that this is not in essence an issue of measuring and metrics. This is in essence a key business issue for the university sector. A key strategic business issue. And the third key message is that I already at this point wish to send a sincere thank you to the organizers. First of all, the chosen theme then. It is indeed a valued one. So impact is on everyone's lips. It relates to research impact and non-academic impact, societal impact. And clearly there's a need to mature our views and perspectives on impact as such. We have several key questions listed in the conference program, and these are really the basic ones, the fundamental ones. What is impact? What do we mean with it? Can it be measured, assessed, evaluated? And if so, how is that carried out? More issues relates to how does the metrics approach, any metrics approach, affect the universities and the research community? How will it affect us in the short run? How will it affect and shape our sector in the long run? It's very pleasing to see that the conference program is full of these topics and related themes, and that assures me highly of the relevance of this year's conference. And when I further look through the program, I see that there is a careful selection of speakers, not only from the Gothenburg area or the Swedish scene, but we have some internationally renowned experts here as well. So I'm assured also of the quality of the program and that the prerequisites are set, that you will all have a great collective learning experience today. So let us have that as a common ambition to further our views on how impact could be measured, but also how impact could be seen as a key strategic issue for the university sector. And clinging to that university business perspective, I mean, it's very clear that we are expected to achieve impact on business and society. This demand is clearer than ever before, and that is for very good reasons, I would say. I'm the head of innovation in the Grapheme flagship, a quite large research and innovation program funded by the Commission. It's 1 billion euro spent on research and innovation in graphene for the oncoming 10 years. When we see the refugee situation develop and escalate throughout Europe, we also see the sensitivity of the European Parliament and the signals that is sent to the Commission. We see that those trends, the demands to cope with social challenges, ecological challenges, and economic challenges are very easily spread from Brussels throughout the funding agencies, like the Commission. And we have the Europe 2020 initiative now some years back. We have the Innovation Union concept stemming from that. Slowly but surely, that concept drips down into the member states, affects our national and regional funding bodies as well. So the Horizon 2020 basis or paradigm, if you like, is slowly but surely affecting how funds are allocated throughout the member states. And the trends in society that hits us, so to speak, are several. We have global business competition, unlike the situation 20 years back or even 10 years back. Asia has awoken. We see that in industrial sectors, but we also see that in our own sector. We see that knowledge production in Asia is picking up, and the volumes are there, and the quality is partly there. So we also face an increased rivalry in our own sector for excellence. Then we have another trend, and that is the rivalry, global competition between countries and regions in countries. So from any regional perspective, we are highly interested in not only measuring what type of impact we do achieve on our businesses and on our society, but further, we would like to showcase that, demonstrate that impact and its related values. Because we are, from a university sector point of view, we are dependent on that society reinvests into our sector. So we need to be part of that circular economy where investments are paid back in order to increase or get a positive spiral from that, increasing returns from that. And on top of it all, we have what we currently see in Europe. We have sustainability challenges, and universities are asked for a stronger contribution to our ability to switch to a sustainable society. And all these trends are expected to last, and they are expected to add in strength as well. It applies that utilization and impact on the basis of the university is also an increasingly important question. And then the issue of measuring it and being able to display it, demonstrate it, will also grow in importance. So the conclusion must be that the questions brought forward in this conference is key business issues for the university sector and for the university sector as part of the society. And clearly for any progressive university, there is a tap of, or there is a source of competitive advantage to be tapped from this. And I think this is really a question all for us to consider today. How can we apply our key learnings from this conference to assess in what ways we can sharpen the output from the university, be a more professional partner, a more vital partner to society without compromising our own professional values. We need still to respect the ground values of the university sector, but my hypothesis is that we have a lot more to do. We have a lot more impact to sustain and to provide without being even close to compromising our ground rules, so to speak. Academic freedom, neutrality, independence, and so on. So this conference, to my view, is a first step, but not the last step to mature our thinking in all these respects. So therefore, that's the reason for me already at this point, considering the relevance of the topics addressed, considering the quality of speakers chosen and themes chosen, together with this very strong group of participants. I would like to already at this point Express my sincere thanks to the organizing committee. Please stand up. All you who have worked with the conference, it's not only Daniel, there are some other persons as well. And it might seem a bit frank, but let's, there we go, Urban. Let's all direct a round of applause to these guys. Because we know that there's a lot more efforts behind the scenes that we can even imagine. Huh? I wish you all a very productive conference, and I'm sorry to say that I have other engagements. I can't stay with you. I wish I could have stayed with you throughout the entire day. I have some very close colleagues. I've asked them to report back their key findings so that we can, at least from a Chalmers University of Technology perspective, review the actions and implications stemming from our key learning from this conference. I would be very certain that we are much better off making our mark after this conference compared to before. So thank you very much.